As I mentioned, one of the biggest advantages in using yeast in life science research is its genetic tractability. Immediately after the discovery of autophagy in yeast, Dr. Olsen's group proceeded to aggressively pursue the isolation of mutants defective in autophagy. They treated yeast cells with a chemical that induces mutations at random positions in the cell's genomic DNA, and using a microscope, looked for mutants that do not accumulate autophagic bodies, even after shifting to starvation medium. After observing no less than 5,000 mutants one by one, they finally succeeded in obtaining a single mutant which did not accumulate autophagic bodies within the vacuole. As you can see here, in contrast to parental cells which accumulated autophagic bodies, no autophagic bodies at all were observed in these mutant cells. Following a convention for naming genes in yeast, they named the mutant APG1-1, where APG stands for autophagy. In this mutant, a certain unknown gene required for autophagy was being impaired by a mutation. Dr. Osumi was not satisfied by this achievement, because he assumed that autophagy, which is a highly dynamic and complex phenomenon, must require many more genes. However, since only a single mutant was obtained after the examination of 5,000 mutants, they decided that continuing the same approach was not the most efficient way forward. In the meantime, they made an important discovery. The APG1-1 mutant, which is defective in autophagy, died earlier than normal cells under starvation conditions. They decided to take advantage of this phenotype for the isolation of more autophagy mutants. In their second attempt to obtain autophagy defective mutants, they started with about 38,000 mutants and first picked up about 2,700 mutants sensitive to starvation, which could be easily found on agar plates using a dye which stains the dead cells. Next, they examined mutants individually by microscopy to check for the accumulation of autophagic bodies. In this second step, the examination of 2,700 mutants resulted in the isolation of 99 autophagy defective mutants. This is in contrast to the first study, in which a single mutant was obtained after examining 5,000 mutants, so the efficiency of mutant isolation was greatly improved by adding a simple step. This is an awesome example of genetic screening for mutants and the power of yeast as a model organism in biology research. Our further genetic analysis of the 99 autophagy defective mutants uncovered 14 genes that were mutated, causing the observed defects in autophagy. Here is a list of the 14 APG genes Dr. Osumi identified. Later on, these genes were renamed ATG, which stands for autophagy related, to avoid confusion, because several other groups identified some of these genes later on using different approaches and reported their findings using different names. Identification of the autophagy genes in yeast and the determination of their sequences immediately allowed us to discover equivalent genes in other organisms, including mammals, just by searching sequence databases on a computer. As I mentioned earlier, the inability to identify the genes controlling autophagy was holding the field back, And this work allowed researchers all over the world to investigate all stages of the autophagy process,